हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग एग्जांपल ऑफ चैप्टर 1 एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस एग्जांपल नंबर 1.2, 1.3 एंड 1.4. टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद एग्जांपल नंबर 1.5. नाउ इट्स अ वेरी लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन बट वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन. इन एग्जांपल 1.5 इट इज गिवन दैट यू हैव बीन गिवन टू स्फीयर्स ए एंड बी where sphere A is suspended with the help of nylon thread. This sphere A is suspended with the help of nylon thread and charge on sphere A is QA. Sphere B is now connected with the insulating handle. Sphere B is connected with insulating handle which is having charge say QB, and they are now placed at distance of 10 cm. This 10 cm, let us say this distance is equal to R. So in this situation the electrostatic repulsion between A and B can be given as F equals to K charge on each sphere QA QB by R square, equation number 1. Now what you are doing, you are taking another sphere C, making in contact with A and then separating. What will happen if I bring another sphere C which is initially chargeless? So initial charge on A is QA, initial charge on C is 0. They both are brought in contact with each other and then separated. They have given that sphere C is exactly identical to sphere A. Identical means it is having same radius as that of A and it is also conducting sphere. So in that case what will happen? A and C will share the charges. Charge will flow from A and C, and as already discussed earlier in conduction, the net charge on A and C both Q A dash will be equal to Q A plus 0 divided by 2, because charge on A is Q A, charge on C is 0 divided by 2. So Q A dash will be QA by 2. Also, they have said that we are connecting this sphere B with another identical uncharged sphere D. So sphere B initially is having charge QB and D is having charge 0. They both are connected and separated. So final charge on B and D, QB dash, will be what? It will be QB plus 0 by 2. So even that comes out to be QB by 2. This is charge on A and charge on B. Final charge on A is QA by 2. Final charge on B is QB by 2. Now, this sphere A and B, after doing this process, sphere A and B, after doing this process, which are having now charge QA by 2 and QB by 2, are separated by distance 5 cm, which is R by 2. Initial distance was R, now they are separated at distance 5 cm. The final distance will be R by 2. And question to us is that what will be new force between A and B? So we have to calculate new force between A and B. F dash, it will be given as K charge on sphere A QA dash, that is QA by 2. Charge on sphere B QB dash, it is QB by 2 divided by R by 2 the whole square. So what will it will become? K QA into QB by 4 upon r square by 4. We can cancel out this 4. So f dash becomes k qa qb by r square, and which is from equation 1 exactly equal to f. So the force doesn't change, it remains same as earlier. See the question 1 again. What was the question? Sphere A and B were having charge qa and qb. They were separated by distance r, and force between them is k qa qb by r square. Now what you are doing? You are bringing in another uncharged sphere C close to A, connecting it with A and then separating. So charge on A and C both will become qa by 2. Similarly, what you are doing? You are taking one sphere D, connecting it with B and then separating. The final charge on sphere B and D will become qb by 2. Now A and B are kept at distance 5 cm, which is exactly half than the earlier distance. So it is r by 2, and what will be new force? Using Coulomb's law, it can be clearly seen that force again comes out to be k qa qb by r square, which is exactly the same as the earlier force. Now next example, number 1.6. We have already discussed this kind of question earlier in equilibrium of charges, but once again we are doing it. See, this triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle, and charges on each vertex Q1, Q2, Q3 are same, and it is equal to Q. At centroid of this equilateral triangle, centroid O, we are placing charge capital Q. So question to us is that what is the net force on this charge placed at the centroid of equilateral triangle? You're getting this question? This is an equilateral triangle ABC, and we are having equal charges Q at all of its vertex. Question asked to us is that what is the net force acting on charge capital Q placed at centroid of triangle? We already have discussed that if you are having a regular polygon, and equal charges are placed at vertex, so net force on charge placed at center will be zero. But we have to prove over here. Let us consider this distance between vertex and centroid is say equal to r. Distance between one of the vertex and center of triangle is given as r. So this central charge Q will be acted upon by force due to all these three charges. Force due to this Q1 on capital Q will be in this direction. This force is vector F1. Force due to Q2 on this central charge is vector F2. Force on this Q due to this Q3 will be vector F3. As in all cases, the charge placed at vertex is small q and distance is r, so we can easily say that magnitude of F1, magnitude of F2 and magnitude of F3, they all are same, and their value will be k q capital Q divided by r square. Now if I write all these three forces, these forces are concentric force. This is F1, this force over here is F2, and this force here is F3. an angle between any two force. See over here, this angle, in this small triangle, this angle is 90 degree, this small angle is 30 degree, so this will be 60, so even this is 60. So between these two forces, angle is 120 degree. Even between these two forces, it can be easily proved that angle is 120, and finally this angle is also 120 degree. Magnitude are same, their opposite angles are same. So it is obeying Lami's theorem that if F1 by sin alpha is equal to F2 by sin beta is equal to F3 by sin gamma, then vector F1 plus F2 plus F3 is equal to 0. It can be clearly seen that F1, F2, F3, they all are same. Angle opposite to F1, this angle is alpha. Angle opposite to F2, this angle is beta. Angle opposite to F3, this angle is gamma. Even alpha, beta and gamma, they all are same. So this condition is satisfied. So we can clearly say that F1 plus F2 plus F3 is 0, and therefore we can say that net force on charge capital Q is 0. This can be solved in other ways also. You can consider this as x-axis, you can consider this as y-axis, resolve F2 into two component, you can resolve F3 into two component, and then by taking sum of F1, F2, F3, it can be proven that net force F is 0. So in many ways we can prove that force on central charge is 0, but remember now, we have already discussed it, if you have a closed polygon and charges on each of its vertex are same, then the force on central charge will always be 0. Now next question, example 1.7, it is given that you have a equilateral triangle A, B and C. The charges on A, B and C are plus Q on A, plus Q on B and minus Q on C. We have to find out over here what is the net force acting on each charge. We have to calculate the net force acting on each charge. The side length of this triangle is equal to say A. Now step by step we can calculate. First let us consider what is net force on charge placed at A. So for this charge placed at A, there will be two forces acting, one due to B, other due to C. This force can be given as force acting on A due to B, that is FAB. And because this is negative charge and this is positive charge, so there will be attraction between these two charges, and this can be written as force that is acting on A due to C. Both forces on A due to B and A due to C are having same magnitude, that is KQ square by A square. Both are having same magnitude, that is KQ square by A square. So net force on A, if I want to find out, I have to use law of parallelogram. This is the net force on A, which is FA. Angle between FAB and FAC will be 120 degree, because this angle is 60, so this can be easily proven that this angle is 120 degree. How can I find out FA? FA magnitude. will be under root f ab square plus f ac square plus 2 f ab f ac cos of 120 degree. F ab f ac we can write down both as f, so this force fa comes out to be f ab is f square plus f ac is also f square plus 2 f ab f ac is f square and cos 120 is minus 1 by 2. This 2 and 2 is getting cancelled. Minus 1 into f square is minus f square. So plus f square minus f square also gets cancelled. So only thing is remaining is under root f square. So it is f which is kq square by a square. This is net force acting on a vector fa. Now similarly, how to calculate net force? Similarly, how to calculate what is the net force acting on this charge plus q placed at B? So force on B due to A will be FBA. Force on B due to C, again is plus q minus q. So between two unlike charges, there will be attraction. So this force can be written as FBC, and by using law of parallelogram, net force, we can write it down as FB. Again in this case, FBA, FBC, FBA and FBC both will be equal to how much? Both will be equal to KQ square by A square, so which is equal to F only. Between these two, FB and FBC forces, angle is again 120 degree. So situation is identical exactly to that of A. So we can easily write down magnitude of FB as under root. I am not writing down FB and FBC now. It can be clearly understood F square plus F square plus 2F square cos 120 is minus 1 by 2. It also comes out to be F only. So net force is what? K Q square by A square. This is net force on B. So net force on A is KQ square by A square, and net force on B is also KQ square by A square. Okay, the directions will be different, but net force is same. Now finally, we have to find out net force on C. How can I find out net force on C? So on C, on this charge minus Q, there will be attraction due to A. So this force is FCA. On this charge placed at C, there is attraction due to B also. So this force is FCB. Again FCA and FCB, they both are same, and both charges are Q, distance is A. So force is what? KQ square by A square, which is F itself. Using law of parallelogram, once again, this is the net force on C. Angle between FC and FCB is 60 degree. So net force magnitude FC is under root FCA the whole square, which is F square, FCB the whole square, once again F square, 2 FCA FCB. 2 FCA is F, FCB is also F, so it again becomes F square into angle, that is cos of 60 degree. So how much is the value? F square plus F square plus 2 F square cos 60 is 1 by 2. This 2 and 2 will get cancelled. F square plus F square plus F square. it under root 3f square. So fc net force is root 3f, that is root 3 kq square by a square. So force on a is kq square by a square, b is also kq square by a square, whereas force on c is root 3 kq square by a square. See here, FA and FB, both forces are kq square by a square, and FC is root 3 kq square by a square. We have already proved this. Now if I add all these vectors, FA plus FB plus FC, how I can write down? FA is actually vector sum of two forces, FAB and FAC. So for FA, I can write down FAB plus FAC. For FB, it is vector sum of two forces, FB and FBC. So we can write it down as FBA and FBC. And finally, for FC, it is also vector sum of two forces, FCA and FCB. So it can be written as vector FCA plus vector FCB. Now we already have this relation that FAB will be equal to minus of FB. Newton's third law, FAB and FBA will be equal and opposite. Similarly, FAC will be equal to minus FCA, FAC and FCA will also be equal and opposite, and FBC and FCB, they will also be pair of, we can say, opposite forces. So FAB and FBA, they will cancel each other. FAC and FCA will cancel, and FBC and FCB will also get cancelled. And therefore, sum of net forces acting on each of the charges placed on vertex comes out to be zero. Very important result for us.